Testing push notifications locally is a highly convenient way to ensure your notifications are working as intended before deploying them to a live environment. It allows developers to debug issues, verify the payloads, and see real-time results without the need for a production setup. This approach saves time, minimizes errors, and provides a controlled testing environment. In this video, I offer a step-by-step guide on how to set up and test push notifications locally, making the process straightforward and accessible for developers at any level. And if you want to meet me on a one-on-one session, go ahead and check out the mentoring sessions. The link is down in the description. So today we are going to talk about push notifications specifically on the simulator. This is an easiest way to test your push notifications. So I'm just going to show you how you can drag and drop an APNS file into your simulator and just see that nice push notification pop up and make sure that everything is set up correctly inside your Xcode project. Okay, so what I have done here is just started off with a brand new Xcode project. I just added a button. That's just it. First thing that we need to do is just enable push notifications. So go under signing and capabilities under your target, click on capability and add in push notifications. Double click over there and it should be added. Mine is added instantly because I already tested it out, but in a few tens of seconds, it will just talk to App Store Connect and it will add it to your project. And also you will see this file pop up right over here. Okay, so we added the capability. Our project may handle push notifications. That's really nice. Now let's take care of the code. First of all, we need to access our notification center. So what we're going to do is just add it as a constant, let notification center equals. Before we do that, we need to import user notification to be able to access it. So let's import user notifications, and that is UN user notification center, and dot current. There we go. So this is our notification center. Why do we need to have this available? Well, we need to, as you have already read this, request push notification access. And that is an asynchronous throwing function. So I'm going to add a task first of all over here, and then a do catch statement. And let's just print out the errors localized description. Of course, you might want to put this into an alert. Okay, so what do we want to do here? Well, as I told you, this is an asynchronous throwing function. So try await and then notification center. And it's suggesting it correctly. Request authorization with some options. And my options are alert, badge, and sound. So basically everything. Okay, so once that is in place, we are going to drag and drop a push notifications, which of course is going to be sent by Apple, but we are going to create our own. With years of experience and a deep understanding of Swift UI, I can guide you through the complexities of building modern iOS apps with clarity and confidence. My mentoring sessions focus on practical, real-world applications of Swift UI, helping you navigate challenges, adopt best practices, and refine your skills. Whether you're looking to deepen your knowledge or tackle advanced topics, my goal is to support your growth as an iOS developer and help you use Swift UI to its fullest potential. The link is down in the description. So let's build and run and let's give authorization. Request push notification access. Let's push on it. And it will say notifications may include alerts, sounds, and icon badges. Just what I was requesting for. Of course, we are going to tap allow right over here. And now it's time for the second part of the tutorial, where we are going to create that APNS file, which we can drag and drop and test it out. So right-click over here and let's create a new empty file. And let's name this. As you can see, it's of type Swift. You may change it right over here, or you want to change it later on, which I will do right now, because this has to be of type APNS. So really different. It's not a Swift file, it's an APNS file. And then what you want to type out is a JSON file. And I'm just going to copy and paste it from my notes over here because I don't want to add any typos. Make sure that you stop the video and edit, copy it out. What you want to have is simulator target bundle, and that is your bundle identifier. Your bundle identifier can be found right over here, okay? And then the APS, so an alert with a body. That's required, and that is our test message. Optionally, you may add a title or a subtitle. Now, you may test this out, just go ahead and get wild with it. So now, if I build and run again, there we go. We are in our application. I'm just going to go outside. That's fine. And then let's just search for our APNS file. There we go. And what I'm going to do is just drag and drop it. And this is your basically your test. So let's just drag and drop this right over here. And there we go. We have a title optional, subtitle optional, and a test message. And of course, it can be dismissible or it will be dismissed automatically by the system after a few seconds. Or you can just tap on it like I'm going to do right now, and it is just going to open up your application too. And this will also open up your application if it's not running in the background. So let's do the setup again, simulator and finder, and let's drag and drop it right over here. And then let's tap on it, and it's just going to open up your app. Really nice. Now I know that my APNS file is ready to go. And that's how simple it is to test your push notifications in the simulator. Now, if you did like these types of videos, go ahead and check out my mentoring sessions. The link is down in the description.